this week on Outdoor Bound TV. We tackle one more viewer-submitted scenario on part two of the Wisconsin Food Plot Project. This time, we'll be creating a staging plot on a wooded piece of property that has only access via a UTV. Then it's off to northern Minnesota, where we spend a beautiful June day on the water with Gail Heig from Bowen Lodge and our good friend and guide, Reed Ylitalo from Wings and Walleye's Guide Service. Take a look at this. Yeah.
That was intense.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Real Deal Mineral, Brew Pub Pizza, Meyer Recreational Buildings, and Colby Chrysler Center.
This mineral is a game changer. I've put the odds in my favor. It's time to close the deal. I wouldn't change a thing. Finally, the buck of a lifetime. Real Deal Mineral. The results speak for themselves.
Brew Pub Pizza is specifically designed with the hungry in mind. It's big, it's bold, and it's outrageously delicious. Brew Pub Lotsa Matzah Pizza is made with your favorite premium meats and veggies, topped with over a half pound of real Wisconsin mozzarella cheese. And now, sign up at any participating Brew Pub Pizza retailer for your chance to win the whitetail hunt of a lifetime in Alberta, Canada, with Outdoor Bound TV host Kurt Walbeck. Brew Pub Lotsa Matzah Pizza, the ingredients for a great time.
Since 1957, Meyer Buildings has offered full design and project management for your farm, equestrian, commercial, and storage building needs. Our recreational building line specializes in the design and construction of affordable, remote area buildings for the outdoorsman.
This is my second Meyer building. I've been satisfied both times. Their design assistance, the quality of the construction, and their attention to detail. It's perfect.
At Meyer Recreational Buildings, we offer custom building solutions for all of your building needs. Log on today for a better way to build.
You know, we all expect a lot from our trucks, whether it's tackling Wisconsin's tough winters, towing that boat to the lake, or getting you to your favorite hunting spot.
The Ram 1500, with your choice of the 28 mile per gallon Eco Diesel or the legendary Hemi Power, air ride adjustable off-road suspension, and optional Ram box.
So make the short drive to Colby Chrysler Center and discover for yourself why so many sportsmen and women have chosen the all-new Ram 1500. Welcome home to Colby Chrysler.
Hi everyone, welcome to Outdoor Bound TV. I'm Kurt Walbeck. On last week's show, we had the first of our annual Wisconsin Food Plot Project. Now this is where we take viewer-submitted food plot scenarios and then we bring in the experts to help us solve these challenges. Last week's challenge was an old farm that's been growing up and hasn't been used for years. The challenge was to create a food plot on the property that would help retain deer on the farm. We also learned a few tips and strategies to utilize on every type of food plot. Let's take a few minutes and review some of these tips right now.
One of the first things that you need to do to create a thriving food plot is to remove all competing grasses and weeds from your plot location. Now, there are many brands of broadleaf herbicides that work well to eliminate unwanted grass and weeds from your plot.
Now, once our spraying is complete, we allow the plot to sit for 7 to 10 days. This allows the weed and grass killer to be completely absorbed by the plant and to kill the root dead. Now it's time to turn up our plot. A simple disc or a rotary tiller is probably the most widely used implement for food plot creation. We're still not ready to plant. Matt Serwa from Real Deal G2 Seeds is here to explain one important step that shouldn't be skipped.
One of the most important things to planting a food plot is having the soil tested. The soil analysis kit you get from Real Deal G2 Seeds is branded to us and they know our product. It's roughly $25, $30 for the test. You send it in, they'll email you the results. Pick 6 to 8 various locations on the food plot. You take a sample and you put it in this bag. After sending your sample in, you'll get the analysis back. So for our pH amending, we're going to use pelletized lime, and we're going to put 200 pounds down on this food plot. For the nitrogen, it's calling for 60 pounds per acre and 40 pounds for potash. So we'll just use, we have some triple 17 that we're going to put down. So once you've amended your soil with the recommended materials and the proper poundages, you're ready to prepare your seedbed and plant your food plot.
Now, the second food plot challenge issued by one of our viewers was to take a completely wooded piece of property with no agricultural fields and create a staging plot where deer would feel comfortable feeding in the early evening after they left the bedding area. The challenge was we had no access for a tractor or traditional tilling equipment.
We're in central Wisconsin, and we're about to cut down all the tall grass so that we can come in and spray it, and then after that come in and till and seed down this food plot back in the woods. Now that we just cut it, now we just need Kurt to come in with his Kubota and spray the field and kill all the weeds.
All right, our soil test is all completed. And as we wait for the results, let's bring in expert James Melker from Land Pride to help explain how we're gonna go about tilling up a plot that we don't have any access to by a tractor and traditional tilling equipment.
Hi, I'm James Melker with Land Pride. On the small food plot that we're working on today, we're working in a confined area where we can't get the tractor and tiller and a bigger seeder in. So we decided to use the Land Pride Plot Ranger. It's designed for ATVs 500cc or larger, or like the RTV. Some of the nice features about the Plot Ranger, it does have two hitches with it, so you could put it behind a small BX series tractor or put in a receiver hitch that the RTVs come with. The one we're using today has a manual ratchet lift, but you can also equip it with an electric lift. Features that make this work really well for food plots is the discs are actually offsettable. Instead of just having a straight angled disc, it's equipped with 16-inch disc blades. It is also equipped with an optional spin spreader, which you can use for seed and fertilizer and pellet lime. That is equipped with a control that run from the seat of the RTV. It also has a packer that you can flip up. It gives you extra weight when you're trying to till up the plots, but then when you're done seeding or before you seed, you can come through and pack and take some of the air out of that food plot so you're not burying the seed when you come back and broadcast it.
Now, many people ask, what is the best type of seed to use for your food plots? Well, for the last 5 years, we've been using Real Deal G2 seeds, mainly because they have some of the highest germination rates in the industry, and that means more plant for your money. Now, they're also a northern blend. What that means is the seed is grown right here in the Midwest and is designed for our shorter, colder growing season. Now for this staging plot, we chose the Real Deal G2 Shed Hunters blend. It provides forage from the time we plant all the way through the late fall. Now as promised, let's head back to the plots 30 days after we planted them. Now I think you'll agree by looking at the results. If you apply the strategies given by our experts and follow each of the steps in order, your plots can turn out just like these.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Mission, HHA Sports, Bert Coyote's Luminoc, and Rapala.
This is my life, the weekend warrior. No more production lines or deadlines. This is why I work 5 days a week. I need speed, power, precision. I expect no less than the best. This is my best. This is my chance. This is my mission.
Simple, efficient, powerful. Mission by Matthews.
Optimizer by HHA Sports. The Optimizer Lite Ultra, voted number one single pin adjustable sight for 10 years running. The Optimizer Speed Dial for crossbows, to the yard accuracy with a single reticle. And the Optimizer Horizon, offering unmatched accuracy from both short and long range firearms. All Optimizer sight systems utilize range dial shoot technology. Ask for Optimizer at a dealer near you.
Luminoc, the original self-contained lighted knock on the market, patented to accept replaceable lithium batteries and designed to work with all carbon arrow shafts while producing the brightest results during any condition. Easily the most durable illuminated knocks to allow up to 40 hours of continuous use and are packaged and crafted to perfection for hundreds of shots. There's only one true Luminoc. Luminoc by Bert Coyote, made in the USA.
Hey, you remember when we were hanging out last night? You know, me, you, Gail.
That's my girl.
You guys are awesome. And then you went to bed.
I was tired.
You were super tired. And then it was just me and Gail.
Mm-hmm.
Alone.
Ah! What?
Oh, yeah!
It's all in the paws. New Shadow Wrap from Rapala.
Last season, we received a record number of photos that you shared with us of animals that you harvested and fish that you caught. And we gave away some great prizes just for submitting your photos to the show. Well, this season, the prizes are even bigger and even better. And all you have to do to be eligible to win is email us your photo or share it with us on Facebook or Twitter.
Prizes include an assortment of plastic baits from Woodcraft Lures, a Yeti cooler from Petrick's Service Station, fish taxidermy services from Mike Liga Taxidermy, a trip for two aboard the Grand Illusion 2 charter boat on Lake Michigan, and this year's grand prize, a 4-day, 3-night fishing vacation at Sunset Cove Resort on Lake of the Woods, Ontario.
And remember, you can't win if you don't submit your photo.
Here are this week's Outdoor Bound TV viewer photos.
Next, we head to northern Minnesota with our good friends Reed Ylitalo from Wings and Walleye Guide Service and Gail Heig from Bowen Lodge. We're looking for some early June walleye action around the Deer River, Minnesota area.
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
jig fishing, I love jig fishing. That's kind of like my thing. I like to jig fish. Do you like rigging or jigging?
I like jigging better.
I do too.
I get bored rigging.
I do too. I get to feel the fish more, I think, when I'm jigging. I don't know. What I do is I visualize the bottom of the lake and like where the fish are, what the jig is doing at the bottom of the lake. So when I'm jigging, that's what I do. I visualize what's going on below the surface and how that jig is popping off of the bottom and what it's doing to the minnow.
There you go. Nice fish, Gail.
Thank you. Nice fish.
Perfect hook set too.
There we go, Reed.
Oh, another nice one, huh?
Yeah.
I'll grab the net for you.
There, we got the old head shake. Look at him go.
Showing some life down there anyways.
Yeah, ooh,
really nice fish.
Yeah, this is a nice fish. You know, we just came through that weeds and it seems like as soon as we got to the back side of that weed, then we had this fish pick it up right away. There we go. That's a nice eater fish, Reed.
Very nice.
Hey everyone, today we're here in northern Minnesota with our good friend Reed Ylitalo from Wings and Walleye's Guide Service. Now, we've had the opportunity to get out with Reed here the last few years here in northern Minnesota, and I tell you what, it doesn't matter what body of water we fish on. Everywhere we go, Reed puts us on some great walleye, smallmouth, crappies, perch, it doesn't matter. It seems like every single body of water up here has great quantities and great species to be able to fish. What do you think? In the box with this one?
Yep.
All right.
Ooh, this one has some shoulders here.
Nice. Ooh, nice walleye.
Perfect.
Very nice. Beautiful fish.
Very nice. Looks like I got another one here, Gail.
All right, well, I'll catch up to you the next one here.
That one bit awfully hard.
That looks like a nice fish.
I'll just swing it out and just have her come right in the net for me. Excellent, thank you.
You're welcome.
I get to share the boat with a good friend, Gail Heig from Bowen Lodge Resort. And we're out here targeting walleyes with a jig and a minnow technique. The water temp is 69 degrees today. We got high suns, and these walleyes are sure hitting these jig and a minnow, and it's just an absolute blast.
Are smallmouth biting on these jigs?
Oh yeah.
Like this, are they?
We caught some in the rocks the other day.
Oh, okay.
6-7 feet of water, just back trolling pretty fast and just rip jigging.
It's all in the hook set.
I think it's a big smallie.
I think you're probably right.
Wow, nice.
Look at that big old bronze back. This one's big.
Oh,
oh, there's more with them. With, yeah.
Look at that.
Oh, that is really nice. Ooh, fun.
Look at that. Beautiful smallmouth.
Wow, beautiful.
Look at that.
Ooh, look at that.
Look at that beautiful brown back. You know, folks, I say it all the time. That is one of the cool things about northern Minnesota and the lakes here in northern Minnesota. You never really know what you're going to catch. We're jigging for walleyes today. It's the month of June. We've got warm weather and we went over some rocks and Reed said, you know what? It's probably gonna be a smallmouth. And he was right. What a beautiful fish.
Very nice. Another smallmouth.
Yeah.
Came to the surface. Good indication that it's probably not a walleye, but still your rod's bent and they are a battle.
They are a fun fish to catch, especially on lighter tackle. Oh, yes.
Oh, there you go.
Nice little tail twister on that one. Back in the lake she goes.
Back in the lake. Ooh. Oh, I got another one here, Gail. And it looks like and feels like it's gonna be a keeper. I'll just go right up and over.
Alley-oop.
And Gail, what do you think we should do with this one?
Well, I think we should keep that one and have it for tonight's dinner. What do you think? Put it in the live well and let's keep it.
The setup I'm using today is a 7'2" medium light tuned up custom rod, and it's a fast action, and I got an 1/8 ounce shiner jig on there, and I'm just hooking the shiner right up through the head of the minnow, and it's giving it a lot of action. And we're moving fairly slow. We're going 0.3 to 0.4 miles an hour, and we're just popping these jigs right along the bottom.
Fish.
Oh boy, that one almost ripped me right out.
Ooh, that's a nice fish.
Looks like a good one, Gail.
It is a good one. Nice, Reed. Ooh, yes. Come on, baby.
Oh, baby.
Wants to stay deep. It's a beautiful walleye. Yep. Beautiful walleye. Come on, honey. Get up in there. There we go. Oh, nice fish. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Great fish.
Very nice. Good job.
Fish.
Big, whatever it is.
It is big. Oh my goodness. This, ooh, whoa,
smallie.
Nice smallie. Yay. Yeah. Whoa, got some run to it. Nice. All right.
Smallmouth, you can tell they're smallmouth when they come right to the surface. And that one, Gail, we got into about 9 feet. We just got in just a tad shallow on that,
okay,
on that inside turn, and we got up in the rocks. And that's,
interesting, yeah.
Kurt just got snagged up, and you just caught yourself a
nice
a big
smallie.
Smallmouth.
Whoa, that's a big one. So jigging for walleyes using a shiner minnow and an 1/8 ounce jig, going over the rocks, and we landed this nice smallmouth.
Nice job. Heck
Thank
of a
you.
Fight.
Yeah, heck of a fight, yeah. Did a little jump out of the water, and here she is.
Ooh, he's pulling.
Oh yeah.
Good fish?
Yeah, it feels like a good one here, Kurt.
Let me give you some help, bud. Man, what a perfect day. It's about 80 degrees and sunny. Actually, no wind, which is not real good for walleye. Ooh, that's a nice fish, Reed. That's a good walleye. All right.
There you go.
Very nice
Thank
walleye.
You, sir. You're saying 80 degrees, 80 no wind, boat's moving real slow. This one is caught in 15 feet of water, high suns, and a jig and a minnow is doing the trick.
You know, it kind of breaks all the rules, doesn't it? A real warm day. We're right here in the middle of the day. I think it's probably between noon and 1 o'clock. There's absolutely no breeze, no wind, no nothing. And most people would never think about going walleye fishing on a day like this, but we just proved it can be done.
Absolutely, yep. And this one looks a little big, so we're gonna unhook it and put it back in the water.
You know, we've put a few nice ones in the box here, and we've released a couple nice ones. So what else do you have up your sleeve on this lake?
Well, we're gonna try to snoop around and see if we can't get ourselves a few more smallmouth and look for some more walleyes in just a little different area. And I got a spot with, comes out of some deep water and comes up on a shelf, and hopefully they're chasing shiners on top of that one.
Let's go give it a try.
Oh, Kurt, you got one too? We got the boat doing circles here.
That's all right. You were a little busy. I set the net down and first time out and another walleye. All right.
There you go.
You know, these are just great eater-sized fish. So, you know, for a nice meal of walleyes, this is going to be absolutely perfect. This one should go probably in that 15-inch range, mm-hmm. I would say. So, should be absolutely perfect for a great meal tonight. Awesome fishing here in northern Minnesota.
Outdoor Bound TV is brought to you by Shea Creek Sports, Rue Motors, Golden Hawk Canoes, and VMC. At Shea Creek Sports, your pursuit is our passion.
Your pursuit. your pursuit.
Go get. Your pursuit.
Your pursuit.
Your pursuit.
Your pursuit.
Our passion.
Shea Creek Sports, conveniently located just north of Medford on Highway 13.
Hi, I'm Tim Rue from Rue Motors. Whether work or play, we have the Kubota RTV for you.
Rue Motors has been serving central Wisconsin since 1947 with a full line of quality Kubota tractors, mowers, and RTVs. Backed by four generations, you can count on the staff at Rue Motors for outstanding sales and service on all of your quality Kubota products at both convenient locations.
Rue Motors, take the short drive up Highway 45 in Burnhamwood or Antigo.
Handcrafted in the heart of Wisconsin since 1968, Golden Hawk canoes are inspired by the tradition of early wilderness explorers and modern-day canoeing know-how. Customized to meet your exact needs with precision, uniformity, and strength. Our unique, full-contour hull design contributes to stability, whether you're hunting, fishing, trapping, or just spending an afternoon on the water. Handcrafted fun and satisfaction for a lifetime. Golden Hawk Canoe.
Where are we headed? Rocks! Better go with the swinging rugby jig!
I know what to do, thanks!
It's articulated, swinging head, lets soft plastics move naturally and freely!
I know! I designed it!
Plus, it's got that extra long Z-bend hook that you love! And
all
it's
right.
Got...
Hey, little help here? Oops, I'm sorry. Did you say something?
Come on, help me! Turn this bag over!
Product and promotional consideration provided for Outdoor Bound TV by these fine sponsors.
Good fish.
Yeah, it is.
Oh, nice big walleye.
Oh, nice walleye.
Guide him right into the net there, Kurt.
Okay. Let's see what I can do. He's not ready to come in yet.
Okay, play him out.
Especially on this 4-pounder.
Yeah, the 4-pound test. And
yeah, you got a
light tackle. Play him out.
Here he comes. Awesome.
There you go.
Look at that. Another great northern Minnesota walleye. Wow. We've had just an incredible day here with Reed Ylitalo and Wings and Walleye's Guide Service out here in the Deer River area of Minnesota. We've put a little bit of everything in the boat today, and it's just been a great day. Thanks again, Reed, for all your help and for taking us out again.
Absolutely. Thank you.
Folks, join us again here next week when we'll bring you more great hunting and fishing action from around the Midwest, around the nation, and around the world, right here on Outdoor Bound TV. Great fish. I don't know why you wait so long, rookies. Look at that beautiful, oh! Right there at the boat. It was Reed's fault.
He's gonna make the fry pan, it looks like.
Yeah. Did you say fry pan? You scared them away again. Every time you say fry pan, they all turn and go the other way. Mm-hmm.